Good afternoon, and welcome to Music at Abington's Christmas Comes concert. This was not the concert we have traditionally presented, certainly wasn't the concert we had anticipated as we made early plans for this season, but much of life has been interrupted by the pandemic. We're really grateful that you've joined us today and thankful to our donors and patrons who have made this season possible, even in unusual circumstances and times. Part of our goal today is to recognize that as the nights are long and dark, and also a sense of isolation has led at times to a feeling of some darkness in many of our lives, that indeed there are a great many acts of kindness and also a sense of joy in this season. Today, particularly in Sweden, but in many places, people maybe began their day with candlelight for Santa Lucia. We know that over the last few nights, Jews have lit candles for Hanukkah. And we know that in all kinds of ways, in this congregation, we have signaled the beginning of our preparations for the coming of Christmas by lighting Advent wreath candles and soon illuminating trees and houses. We hope the program today gives you a chance just to contend with the places where light is trying to break in the darkness in your life and in this moment. So we welcome you as Christmas comes. I begin with an excerpt from a poem called When Christmas Comes by Virna Sheard. It's a poem that balances the almost immeasurable joy of young children at the Christmas special season with the more complex and balanced emotions of the adults who love and care for those children in this season. Little one, for thee, the twinkling candles bright and gay. For me, the purple shadows and the gray when Christmas comes. For thee, the friends that greet thee at the door. For me, the faces I shall see no more when Christmas comes. But ah, for both of us, the mystic star that leadeth back to Bethlehem afar when Christmas comes. For both of us, the child they saw of old, that evermore his mother's arms enfold when Christmas comes.
Comfort, O comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly.
Thank you.
Christmas Carol by Paul Lawrence Dunbar. Ring out, ye bells, all nature swells with gladness at the wondrous story. The world was lorn, but Christ is born to change our sadness into glory. Sing, earthlings, sing. Tonight a king hath come from heaven's high throne to bless us, the outstretched hand o'er all the land is raised in pity to caress us. Come at his call, be joyful, all, away with mourning and with sadness. The heavenly choir with holy fire their voices raise in songs of gladness. The darkness breaks and dawn awakes, her cheeks suffused with youthful blushes, the rocks and stones in holy tones are singing sweeter than the thrushes. Then why should we in silence be when nature lends her voice to praises, when heaven and earth proclaim the truth of him for whom that lone star blazes? No, be not still, but with a will strike all your harps and set them ringing. On hill and heath, let every breath throw all its power into singing.
Thank you.
reading from Luke's Gospel. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. Joseph went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night.
Thank you.
Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." Had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart.
Thank you.
The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. This is the good news of the Christmas gospel.
During this season, as we gather around stories and songs, one of the reasons that we gather is to encourage one another to hear these stories again and to let them lighten within us those hopes that might have grown dim over the past year. So I want to say a special word of thanks at this place in the program to Erik and to Joan and Ruth for their musical contributions to make this possible. I want to thank my colleague, Kirby Lawrence Hill, who is the pastor here, for reading and sharing with us the good news of the Christmas gospel. I'm John Sall. I'm the director of music ministries here, and I'm so grateful to this congregation and to the Music at Abington committee for the ways that they have engaged a community, even in a challenging time. One final word of thanks goes to Lily, who is our technical director and videographer for the day. So with my thanks to each of them and to those many patrons and donors who make programs like this possible, we'll move into a closing section of the program, one that looks specifically at carols and the way that they might enlighten us with hope during this season. Howard Thurman shares with us, "I will light candles this Christmas, candles of joy despite all the sadness, candles of hope where despair keeps watch, candles of courage for fears ever present, candles of peace for tempest-tossed days, candles of grace to ease heavy burdens, candles of love to inspire all my living, candles that will burn all year long." Nowell by Ann Porter. When snow is shaken from the balsam trees and they're cut down and brought into our houses, when many clustered sparks of many colored fire appear at night in ordinary windows, we hear and sing the customary carols. They bring us ragged miracles and hay and candles and flowering weeds of poetry that are loved all the more because they are so common. But there are carols that carry phrases of the haunting music of the other world, a music wild and dangerous as a prophet's message or the fresh truth of children, who, though they come to us from our own bodies, are altogether new, with their small limbs and bird-like voices They look at us with their clear eyes and ask the piercing questions God alone can answer.
Thank you.
Friends, we want to thank you for joining us. I want to thank my fellow performers, including Kirby, our help in the back with Lily, and to wish you a very Merry Christmas. We look forward to chances to be together, hopefully soon. And also, we hope that today has provided a sense of joy in this season and something that will keep both your voices and your hearts singing, as we know that in just these few days, Christmas comes. Thank you and good night.